Shalom, Shalom, and to all the brothers and sisters out there, Islam, to all of the Muurs. Once again, it's Tazadaq, back giving you some more right knowledge, the Israelite Nobel Adept, Tazadaq Shah Bey, the aboriginal Israelian West Asian inhabitant of Muur, the Pre Columbian civilized historian, scholar. That is I. Nevertheless, you know, I've been trying to actually get you Israelites and you Muurs to coalesce and come to the reality that you are actually the same people. But nevertheless, just some brief history on Muur, or what you refer to as America, so on and so forth. Our ancestors, many of us, did not come here as slaves, and I need you to understand that. Many of our ancestors were actually prehistoric. Prehistoric mound builders and prehistory and prehistory. So it is time that the world know the truth and witness the facts. Which is not our story, but actual facts. Now, enough of his story, which actually has been dispelled by, you know, our actual facts. The lies has actually been dispelled. We are the diggers. We are the Asiatics. A lot of you Israelites like to say that we're not Asiatics because you don't understand geography and you do not understand the etymology of words. When I say we're the Asiatics, we are indeed the true inhabitants of the land Asia Major, which actually happened to be where Mesopotamia fall when you look at West Asia. So don't tell me that we're not Asiatics. Just say you do not understand. So I suggest that you go and look back at, you know, the Western Asian hemisphere. We are also referred to as the Big Buffalo people. We're referred to as the Ancient Ones, among many other terms, Israelite, Muur, so on and so forth. So, now, how many of you knew that there is actually legal certified documents of colonial Spanish and French invaders that Europeans actually call explorers, you know, conquerors, invaders, that we refer to them as, that actually identify us as the ancient inhabitants and occupants of what they near refer to as America, Muur. That's us. Now, after these Edomites, after these, you know, so-called Europeans or so-called white people, whatever term you may refer to these people as, actually came to our land, Muur, America, you know, they changed certain names like Washitaw and Tunica to Washington and Turner. So all of our people, you know, they have no clue of some of their noble history. They have no clue because of these misnomers. They alter their names such as these. They alter the name Washitaw to mean Owachitaw, which is actually a misnomer. So they changed it from Washitaw, W-A-S-H-I-T-A, and spelled it O-U-A-C-H-I-T-A. That's a misnomer. Washitaw actually has essentially now come to mean the ancient ones or the black ones. And it was actually clearly printed on the original maps of the Spanish land grants, the river named Rio Negro. It was printed there, or the River of the Blacks, for a clear, a more precise understanding, and is actually simultaneously referred to and labeled as the Rio or Ouachita, River of the Ouachita, because they keep changing names around to keep our people all discombobulated and confused. Now, many occupants incorrectly actually classified us as Indians. So you hear people say all of the time in these history classes, oh, the Indians, so on and so forth. No, we are not Indians. That is another misnomer. We are indigenous, many of us, to this land. Sure, many of us came here in the holds of slave ships, or many of our people, because I didn't, came here in the hold of slave ships, as you hear many Israelite brothers and sisters say. But here is where you must concur with the Muurs that many of us did not come here in the holds of slave ships. Don't subject us to just that history. You know, that, you know, our people are classified often by, you know, these Edomites as Indians, descendants of people who actually migrated in waves across the Bering Strait and the Pacific Ocean. Yet, research indisputably shows we had actually established and elaborated communities and social order for thousands of years before the arrival of any kind of barbarous invaders onto our land, Muur. So, the so-called red population of the Western Hemisphere, you know, who claim no ownership to the land, are indeed our brothers and sisters. They're our brothers and sisters, who actually also emerged from our empire. Now, the names Blackfoot, Tar Heels, like you hear him say, the North Carolina Tar Heels, are actually examples of lucid attempts to hide our true identity. So, many of your facts are not facts at all. They're not actual. They're actual lies, and your facts are backwards. Yet, you know, there's other names actually used, you know, to divide our people, such as Creeks, Cherokees, Hopi, Iroquois, Hokum, Navajo, Shoshone, Nazatec, Bioloids, Seminoles, Chickasaw, and so on and so forth. The cultures of the Amalekites and the Toltecs and the Mayans and the Aztecs and the Incas, who actually evolved into sophisticated societies in areas known as Central and South America today, Muur, can actually be linked to distinct traditions and artifacts that actually originated in the Washitaw Mound Empire. Now, I want you to take note that I mentioned Yah at the end of that word. Now, you notice how Mound Yah has the name of God in it, Yah, on the end of that thing. Let you know that there's Hebrew influence in it. But many of you, your knowledge does not transcend the ghetto. Or your knowledge does not transcend this man's textbooks, which actually has you all confused and discombobulated. You know, that's precisely why you are confused and discombobulated, because you trust in lies, you trust in oppression, so you can't coalesce as one people. But it's time to qualm Yasha Allah. So, you know, in what they now refer to as North America, the area of the Alleghenies to the Rocky Mountains, from Canada to the Gulf of Mexico, including, you know, the West Floridian areas and West Paco, actually encompasses the domain of the empire of Washitaw Mound Yah, a landmass approximately 30 million acres. And history actually records networks of actually extensive trading across our land for approximately 3,000 years. Now, you go back and take that to your Edomite, so-called historian and scholar. You know, this is the region of the United States that's actually essentially illegally tried to claim as the Louisiana Purchase. That's ours. It is the same region that Abraham Lincoln tried, you know, to coin as the Egypt of the West. And actually, he actually proposed it to creed to the ex-slaves. Why did he do that? Because he knew already that it belonged to the ancient people. It belonged to us already. It belonged to the ancient ones, as they referred to us as. So, they also referred to it, brothers and sisters, as a neutral strip, a no man's land. So, you know, in the 1800s, many of our indigenous ancestors that, you know, they lie and refer to them as Indians and so on and so forth, was driven out at gunpoint over, you know, these scarce lands. So where did they go? Where did they go? This is what is known as the infamous Trail of Tears. These native people from Carolinas, the Georgia, Tennessee, Florida, Alabama, Mississippi, Arkansas, and Texas was actually returned to the lands of the ancient ones, the Washitaw proper. They were driven across the Washitaw Mountains, through the Washitaw Forest, to the basins of the Washitaw Rivers in the heart of the Washitaw Empire. This area was actually later known or named the Indian Territory or Oklahoma. Now, you don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourselves. Stop getting all your information from the internet. The United States military knew precisely where to return our people. Where is that? Because they knew where they got them from. Now, any map of the continent would actually show the locations to the Washitaw Rivers. And, you know, they began at the Gulf of Mexico in the delta of the Mississippi River. Understand that. And Washitaw is just plural for Washitaw without the W on the N. So, you know, with that, I'm going to bring this little dialogue to a close. And understand this. You know, when I fall on my face and pray, I talk to the Most High. When I meditate in silence, the Most High talks to me. And with that, I'm going to say Shalom and Islam to all of the listeners. And once again, it is I, Tazadaq, the adept, aboriginal, Israelian, West Asian, Israelite, Muur, coming at you from Muur, what they now ignorantly refer to as America. So be sure to tune in to the YouTube channel, share this video, and subscribe. And you have a duty and responsibility to teach others what you learn. Shalom and Islam.